It is the 89th minute of the game. Japan is leading 2-1, a score that meant that Japanese will qualify for a ticket to the America World Cup. The Doha Stadium, filled with 60,000 eager and excited Japanese, cheer with the banner USA 45. The referee raised his left hand, corner for Iraq. Rai Ramos, the naturalized Japanese player from Brazil, anxiously yet excitedly asked the referee using Portuguese, "Does the game end when the corner kick ends?" "Yes," the Swiss referee replied politely, "and in this case, we qualify for America." At that point, the dream of qualifying for the first World Cup, the dream that Japanese has chased for 20 years, is so close to them. In 1992, three major breakpoints happened to Japan. First, they renovated their league system from semi-amateur to professional, which we call it as J-League today. This marks that Japan becomes the fourth team after South Korea, North Korea, and Hong Kong to have a professional football team. Second, they hire a Dutch coach called Oft. He makes significant changes and revision to the Japanese team and increase their overall skill. In 1992 Asian Cup, Japan won it under the Netherlands coach, which is the first international title Japan have won. In that game, Japan defeated China 3-2, marked the second time since the 20th century that Japan have defeated China in a major tournament. Third, Japan registered in the 1994 World Cup qualifier, which is their 8th attempt to qualify for a World Cup since 1950. The Dutch coach will still lead the team. The 1994 World Cup qualifier for AFC features 29 teams competing for 2 berths. In the first round, 25 teams were separated into 6 groups, just like 1990 World Cup qualifier. Japan was paired with United Arab Emirates, Thailand, Bangladesh, and Sri Lanka during the first round, where Japan was chosen to host the first cycle while UAE is chosen to host the second. This group is considered to be a difficult group. United Arab Emirates is the 1990 World Cup finalist and is a top 8 team that plays in the 1992 Asian Cup. Thailand is considered to be a powerhouse in the Southeast Asian region. In the 1992 Asian Cup qualifier, they defeated South Korea 2-1 that led to their elimination from the qualifying stage. They also have a very talented player called Piapon, who is considered to be one of the best Southeast Asian players in the 20th century. In the 1984 Olympic qualifier, it scored a hat-trick against Japan, helping Thailand to win the match with a score of 5-2. It is going to be a very tough qualifier for Japan. Itokatsu, the main character of this story, ran down a huge tree near the Tokyo National Football Stadium. "Dad, Dad, look, look, those blue persons are in." Sekai, who is Katsu's kid, shouted and paused Katsu's mind. The game is going to start. The blue samurais march into the tournament, and on the right side is the Thailand team, in which Sekai calls it as the Red Boss because they wear red jerseys. "Well, well, and in the end, we are going to defeat the Red Boss, just like how you win the Super Mario, right?" Sekai nodded. "And the knight defeats the boss, and the knight defeats the boss," Sekai chanted. Listening to Sekai's chant and the 11 blue persons, suddenly, his unmountable memories and flashbacks start to fill his brain. After 12 years of absence, Japan returned to the World Cup qualifying in 1974 for the berth allocated to Asia and Oceania team. After 110 minutes of dominance, shots, and furious attacks using physicalities by the Israeli team, Onana's goal puts the Japanese football team into the death sentence from advancing to the next round. Kawamoto is a key player in that Japanese Japanese team. He ended up becoming the coach of Gamba Osaka, the team where Katsu watched since he's 7. 4 years later, paired with Asian powerhouse Israeli and South Korea, Japan's skill is inferior compared to the two. With 1 point in 4 games, Japan failed to advance from the group stage shamefully, but with dignity. Being the co-founder of J-League and one of the president from the Japanese FA, Kamato is a key character to Japan football's modern success since the 21st century. However, he did not bring sufficient fortune to the Japanese team. Consecutive losses against China PR and the late goal conceded by North Korea in extra time in the 1982 World Cup qualifier eliminates them again. 4 years later, the team faced South Korea in the final round of the Zone B, in which the winner would qualify for a ticket in Mexico. Despite being so close for their first World Cup, a late goal scored by South Koreans in the Seoul Olympic Stadium terminated their chances of being the fortunate one. The referee's whistle terminated his match. The match against Thailand began. It started with Thailand and Japan having equal chances, but slowly, Japanese gradually controlled the flow of the game and started creating some opportunities. In the 29th minute, a player hits the ball in the front. Mira immediately sends a scoring opportunity. Under the defense of two Thai players, he immediately shoots it out to the goal. The goalkeeper identifies to the direction of the ball but fails to respond it. Score! Japan 1-2-0! The crowds are cheering, the Japanese flags are waving everywhere. People are celebrating this victory. Japan! Japan! Katsu shouted so excited that he forgot his amateur. He almost fell down to the ground, but fortunately he grabbed a fat branch which saved himself from a potential death. After the goal, Piapong and the Thailand team started various attempts to equalize the game, but fortunately, Japanese did not give the opportunity for that and kept that match to the end of the game. A few days later, Japanese faced Bangladesh and Sri Lanka in their home stadium. The two teams is way inferior compared to Japan, so Japan achieved a triumph in the two games, respectively 8-0 against Bangladesh and 5-0 against Sri Lanka. A better news arrived after the two games. United Arab Emirates only win a margin of 5 goals when facing the same two opponents, which means that United Arab Emirates' goal difference is already 8 less than Japan after 3 games. During the World Cup qualifier, there are already some Japanese players demonstrating their talent. For example, Miura. He scored a total of 6 goals during the 3 games. He's also the key player that puts Japan into the 1998 World Cup during the qualifying stage, even though he's not chosen in that World Cup. Like, I just don't understand why the Japan coach doesn't choose him. Perhaps like he just thinks different than what our like what the fans think, perhaps. By the way, this player is still playing today despite he's already 50 years old. Japan's next opponent is United Arab Emirates. UAE is a powerhouse of West Asian football at that time. In the first World Cup qualifier they attend, they stunned everyone by eliminating the Saudis, who are the 1984 Asian Cup and who are the 1984 Asian Cup champion and who has top players like Mujad. 4 years later, they made it one step further by making it to the World Cup after drawing with South Korea. In the past, when facing Western Asian team like UAE, Japanese often try to defend UAE on physical strengths, which is something that they are weaker compared to the top West Asian team. As a result, Japanese bodies gradually doom with tiredness and in the end make them powerless to defend the goal from the United Arab Emirates side. Under the renovation of J1 League, the Netherlands coach and the team learned to use their football skills such as dribbling, passing to avoid directly competing against teams like UAE on physical strengths. This especially helps if they have naturalized players such as Rai Ramos, as Brazilian players tend to be good at dribbling, passing, and those relevant football skills. During their match against UAE, Japanese received a corner during the 20th minute. A player hits the corner and it randomly lands on Japanese player's head and bounces up. The UAE immediately fell into chaos, and under that chaotic moment, another player gets the chance and scored heavily using a header. 1-2-0 lead. After scoring, Japanese players become more excited to win the game because they knew that given that they already have an 8 goal difference before the game, winning this game is almost equivalent to direct qualification to the second round. 15 minutes later in the second half, Japan gets another corner. The Japanese player hits the ball hard. Both UAE and Japanese players tried to hit the ball but both failed and the ball landed directly in the net after a magical curve. 2-0 lead. Instantly, the Japan National Stadium is filled with joy and people are cheering, including Katsu. Katsu is so excited that he suddenly jumped from the tree into the Tokyo Stadium. He took off his clothes and runs directly into the field. "Victory! Victory! Japan qualifies for the final round!" he shouted. That night, people cheer for hours after the game ends. Katsu is so excited. The victory and the fact that Japanese qualified for the final round is like an excitement dose. A dose is so fragrant, it allows him to forget the pain, the trauma he suffered. The past 2 years is so hard for him. He suffered from losing job after the economic crisis, suffering from having to rent and living a much smaller building as a result of being unable to pay the loans for the apartment, suffering from repeated judgment of loser and failure from friends, neighbors, and the local media in Japan, everything under the excitement and confident mood. An idea popped up to his mind. Let's escape to Doha. Immediately, he called his Qatari brother. Hello, sure, you are moving to Qatar. Wow, that's amazing, and I'm sure that you will love Qatar. Job referral, absolutely. I know various Qatari companies that are currently hiring migrants for Qatar job. I'm sure that you will find jobs there. Okay, see you. With that in mind, and the hope that he could definitely have a better life in Qatar compared to Japan, he immediately started preparing everything. Obtaining a Qatari job is difficult, especially if he's in Japan, because at that time, job searching website like Indeed did not even exist. So he has to search on public forums to seek for a chance of getting a job. But fortunately, after a month of searching, and because of the job referral, he successfully obtained a job. CAD designer, 6-hour week, $4,000, work permit sponsorship provided. When he first sees the acceptance letter through the mail, he immediately shouted out, even though he has to admit that his salary is nothing compared to the one he earned during the golden age. At least it provides him with a living, provides a home, and a chance of resurgence. And after finding a job, everything else should be simple. He bought a ticket to the Doha, Qatar, and sold his house in Tokyo, Japan. After all those preparations are ready, his family boards on the plane to Qatar. Farewell, Japan. Just like how his life progresses, the story of Asian qualifier progresses as well. Japan plays their remaining 4 games in the United Arab Emirates, in which they remained unbeaten, winning 3 and drawing with United Arab Emirates. This meant that with 15 points, they have earned a ticket to the final round, which is something that they failed to achieve 4 years ago. The group winners of other groups also came out. Iraq, Iran, North Korea, South Korea, and Saudi Arabia qualified. The only surprise in the first round comes in Qatar, where despite having various naturalized players and despite being the third place of the previous World Cup qualifier, they got eliminated by the North Koreans. And the China PR, who has good players at that time, but is driven by a German coach who basically knows nothing about the team. At the AFC Congress meeting, debates on the location where the final round should be hosted arise. East Asian teams want their matches to be held in Singapore or Malaysia, because the temperature in Doha or Riyadh is unbearable for those Asian teams. West Asian teams want their match to be held in West Asian countries such as West Asian cities such as Manama, Doha, or Baghdad, because they are more familiar with it. In the end, the West Asian teams win the argument and the game is held in Doha, Qatar. The final rule of this game is quite simple. The 16 plays in a single round robin after the round robin complete, the top 2 teams qualifies for the World Cup. Hearing the news from the TV, Kansai immediately started to analyze Japan's odds of qualifying to the next stage in Japan forums. Among the 5 teams, Saudi is the 1984 and 1988 Asian Cup champion, and they have very talented players like Majed. In fact, since he arrived in Doha, he has already heard more than 10 Qataris complimenting how good Majed is. But considering they failed the previous 2 World Cup qualifiers disgracefully, Japan has a chance of getting at least a point from them. Iran has some very good players who are already demonstrating their talent, such as Ali Dai and Goma Hamadi. In 1996, Ali Dai destroyed the South Koreans by scoring a thrilling 4 goals in the Asian Cup quarterfinal. South Korea is our biggest rivalry, and we have never beaten them before in the World Cup qualifier. So it's very difficult for us to get even 1 point from them. But considering how strong they are, they're definitely going to advance like 1 or 2 rounds earlier by defeating every single team, just like 1990. Like, if every team loses South Korea, then it means that every team does not lose to South Korea, because like no team gains advantage from the other just by playing against South Korea. North Korea and Iraq are relatively inferior compared to the 3, so we definitely need to get like at least 3 or 4 points from them. In this case, 6 points should be enough. It should be enough, Katsamamo. United States can't let Iran, Iraq, and North Korea qualify, right? They're under economic sanction. I just read the news yesterday that they have to, like, their citizens are already getting panicked about, like, the chance that those teams are possibly qualifying into the final stage. So in this case, we definitely only need to compete against Saudi and South Korea. But again, can we defeat those two as well? Perhaps not. Daddy, what are you talking about? Zikan suddenly went near his side. Are you worried about Japan not going into the World Cup? During the last 6 months, he has repeatedly heard the father talking about World Cup, Japan, and qualifying for more than 5 times a week. Well, yes. In this case, Japan's an Astro Boy. He's going to defeat all those evil teams. The red boss, the blue boss, the white boss, the Asian boss. Okay, ignore that Asian boss. Katsusa did not speak. Well, Dad, can I become a football player when I grow up? I want to score for Japan, just like Miori. What the hell are you saying? You should only be a doctor or lawyer when you grow up. Now go study and talk to me again when you have become a doctor. Emotional damage! Oh, sorry, this is not the right channel. Sure, Dad, it's 10 o'clock, I'm going to sleep. Oyazumi, Ota-san? Oyazumi? After his kid's sleep, Katsusa sighed. Ah, the kids are just being unrealistic today, and they are not following the right path that I asked him to follow. But after thinking about, there are millions of excited Japanese, like millions of Japanese kids who are interested in the football, he realized that within 5 to 10 years, Japanese football is definitely going to, like, prosper and become one of the top teams in Asia. Just like South Koreans, the 1980s Kuwait, the 1950s, and the 1960s Israeli. Japan started its first match against Saudi Arabia. Japan started with a 3-4 formation, and similar to what Katsusa is expected, Japan starts with their best player. For example, Masa Naga, the 1992 Asian Cup goalkeeper from Japan, and Moriyasu, the midfielder who is currently the Japanese coach and the coach who lead Japan to the, like, round of 16 in the 2022 World Cup by defeating Spain and Germany respectively. And Miori, one of the best forwards in Japan at that time. Japan's strategy primarily adapts with Brazil's strategy at the time, which is the use of personal football skills such as passing and dribbling. They are using that strategy because at that time, Japan sets the goal of learning to Brazil. And the person that they are learning, the national team that they are learning to, also changes over time. In the 2010, around the 2010-ish, they are learning from Spain. Because Spain is, like, one of the best team at that time. They have won the 2010 World Cup and have won the 2008 and 2012 Euros. And after that, they started to sort of develop their own strategy that they can use to defeat top European team instead of just learning from top European team. So that's definitely an achievement and improvement for them. Saudi Arabia is also not bad at those, like, football skills, and they also have good physical abilities. Throughout the game, Japan has more possessions given the strategy they are using, but the possession did not translate to more critical chances in the game. They have a very good opportunity in the beginning, but that opportunity is a clear offside. In the game, the game ends with a 0-0 draw. On the same day, South Koreans demonstrate their superior skill in Asia by defeating the Iranians 3-0. While North Korea make a significant comeback, with 0-2 in the first half, they managed to score 3 goals in the second half and win by 3-2 in that game. During match day 2, Japan faces Team Mali. Similar to the previous game, Japan has a quite good opportunity in the beginning, but the goal is first interrupted by 3 Iranian players, and after the ball passes back to another Japanese player, it got kicked too hard. Ramos also missed another opportunity in the first half. Iran also had a good opportunity where Darin Shah could face a goalkeeper directly without interference from other Japanese player, and Ali Dai could not score a goal for Iran when he's facing an empty net that is literally just 5 meters ahead. Throughout the game, the team mainly paid extraordinary attention to Ryan Ramos and Miori, causing them not to be able to create good opportunity to score for the team. This is the primary reason like Japan is not winning this game, aside from missing critical chances to score. The first half of the game remains 0-0, but Ali Daei and another Iranian player's goal has secured a victory for Iran. Even though Nakayama scored a goal afterward, Japan loses the game by 1-2. Compared to the first match day where the three East Asian teams remain unbeaten, this time the three East Asian teams become winless. Saudi wins North Korea 2-1, while South Korea tied Iraq 2-2 after a long-lasting fight. Moriyasu recalled later that after only getting 1 point in the two games, the entire team feels doomed, as they believe that they cannot get into the 94 World Cup anymore. They believe that it is the end of the world. End of the war, which is normal. At that stage, the only team that has 1 point or less is Japan and Iraq. But Iraq has higher goal scores, so this meant Japan is at the bottom of the group after the two rounds. During the third match day, Japan must win the game to stand a single chance of getting into the top two. But fortunately, Yura saved the entire team. He scored two goals during this game, and this, combined with Nakayama's goal in the second half, helped Japan to secure a 3-0 victory against the North Korea. A few days later, they are facing South Korea, a team that they have never won before in a World Cup qualifier. South Korea had the opportunity during the corner kick, where the player's unexpected far shot around 30 minutes has passed all players, including the goalkeeper, who did not catch the ball. However, the ball is shot a bit away from the net and did not score. A few minutes later, Yoshida kicks the ball to Miura, and Miura scores the goal after passing to the goalkeeper. With this only goal, Japan won 1-0 to South Korea, and this is the first time in history that Japan have won South Korea in the World Cup qualifier since 1950. The Doha Stadium, filled with excited Japanese, has burst into cheer. After the fourth match day, the results are as follows. Japan, 5 points, goal difference 3. Saudi, 5 points, goal difference 1. South Korea, 4 points, goal difference 2. Iraq, 4 difference, goal difference 0. Iran, 4 points, goal difference negative 2. North Korea, 2 points, goal difference negative 3. By the way, the rule for that time is a win is equivalent to 2 points, a draw is equivalent to 1 point. It is not the 3-1-0 rule. The 3-1-0 rule is used after the 1994 World Cup, which is after this qualifying tournament. Based on the result, all 6 teams except North Korea have the chance of qualifying for the World Cup. The match in the final match day are as follows. Japan vs Iraq. South Korea plays against North Korea. Iran plays against Saudi Arabia. If Japan wins, he will qualify directly regardless of the result of other groups. If Japan secures a draw, they will have qualified as long as one of the three conditions holds. First, Japan wins or draws Saudi Arabia in the final round. Second, South Korea loses, draws, or wins only one goal against North Korea. On the other hand, South Korea have to win North Korea's two goals in order to stand the chance of getting the top two. Since 1986, South Korea have never been so close to an elimination in the World Cup. Like even after 1986, South Korea having never been so close to that to an elimination. Like 2018 is a chance where they are a bit close to eliminating, a bit close from not able to get into the 2018 World Cup. But like that game, in the end, like in the last game, even if they lose to Uzbekistan, they still have a decent chance of like getting into at least an intercontinental playoff, because that game, after that game, Syria only has 13 points and China here only has 12 points. So both South Korea and Uzbekistan has 14 points. So depending on the goal difference, because I don't remember what the goal difference is at this point, Japan, South Korea could either get into second points or intercontinental playoff. Both of them like is very beneficial to South Korea. Like, They still have a very high chance of surviving that stage and qualifying to the 2018 World Cup, even if that happens. Similar to the previous two games, Japan continued to use 4-3-3 formation that they used to defeat South Korea and North Korea. Japan got a very fortunate start. The shot from Nakayama was miraculously bounced on the post, which caused chaos in the Iraq national football team's defense. Miura immediately scored a goal in a 1-2-0 in 5 minutes. Despite Iraq desperately seek for equalizing the game, they did not and convert them into goals. The game ended as 1-0 in the first half. Kazawa was on the bench, eagerly using his cell phone to find out the live result on the other two sides, which start at the same time. But after a few minutes, he felt and decided to wait for the announcement. After a few more minutes, the announcement on the Doha Stadium rang. The current score on the other two stadiums are the following: Saudi Arabia 2-1 Iran, South Korea 0-0 North Korea. Reflecting on the scoreboard, it would mean the following: Japan 7-point goal difference 4, Saudi 7-point goal difference 2, South Korea 5-point goal difference 2, Iraq 4-point goal difference negative 1, Iran 4-point goal difference negative 3, North Korea 3-point goal difference negative 3. If the score remains to the end of the 90 minutes, Japan could qualify even if they lose Iraq by less than 2 goals. Excitedness has spread over the Japanese fans filled with Doha Stadium. People raise the banners as they have prepared, USA 45. Kansai already starts to imagine the moment Japan is in the American World Cup. Will they get a point? Maybe if they face some like weak CONCACAF minnows, like Haiti or Cuba or like or whatever. Will they secure a victory? Perhaps if they got paired with Bolivia. Will 2 points make them to knockout stage? Definitely if those strong Argentina, Spanish, French, Dutch, England people be sympathetic to them and score only 1 goal to them. While Katsa is thinking, a sudden news has interrupted his mind. During the second half, Iraq player Radi gets the ball in just less than 10 minutes from the net. Two Japanese players try to get the ball before Radi, but they all fail. Radi then hits the ball to the net. Iraq equalizes the game. At this stage, South Korea already scored 2 goals against North Korea, and Saudi versus Iran score becomes 3-2. This meant that Japan must score another goal to qualify for the World Cup. But fortunately, this time Nakayama stands out. He scored another goal and leads the game to 2-1, a result that meant Japan would qualify. After Nakayama scored another goal, Iraq still tries to equalize the game but did not have so many opportunities to do so. The time gradually flies, 60, 70, and now 89 minutes. The fourth official raised the card, written 2 on it, which meant there will be 2 minutes of added time. 3 minutes and we are at the World Cup. Iraq gets a corner kick. Meanwhile, the South Korea and the North Korea game remains at 3-0 and Saudi Arabia 4-3 Iran. With this goal, Iraq is impossible to get into the top 2, while Japan will qualify as long as they survive the corner kick. JAP hits the ball, but towards another Iraq player instead of the net. Mira was surprised by it that he fails to get the ball. The Iraq kicks the ball to the center and scores through a header. 2-2. It's doom! Immediately, every single player collapsed because of this score. It meant that they are impossible to qualify. Japan made a long pass to seek to score again, but this is clearly offside. The referee then blows the whistle. The game ends 2-2. There are many interpretations to why Japan failed to qualify for the World Cup. Some common ones are bad performance from specific players like Ramos, often inability to tell the team to stay cautious, losing Iran a few days ago in match day 2. But the key reason I believe that qualifying World Cup, that task is put into a very important position at the time. It has gone beyond the area of football, instead becoming a source of national pride for Japanese under the era where they suffer from the economical crisis and job loss. You can see that based on the game, where Japanese players both mentally and physically collapse when the score is 1-1 and 2-2 respectively. They face the same thing 4 years later when they are playing against Iran during the third place playoff of the 1998 World Cup qualifiers, where they are like 1-2 during the second half. But fortunately, this time the agony did not happen again. Japan scored a goal to tie the game to 2-2 and a golden goal in like 119 minutes helped Japan to win the game 3-2. It is joy, which we call it as Joy of Johor Bahru. This is the end of this video. If you like this video, remember to like and subscribe to the North America Mass Contest Go! Thank you so much and enjoy your life.